What's up, guys? Got a little update for you. Had recently bought the Glock 26 in 9mm. I was waiting for a while to get a holster for it, and I had bought the Comtech Minotaur holster. Some of you may notice that I have done some modifying to this holster just to customize it to a subcompact size gun. This area back down here had excess leather, and basically I just cut it right off, which makes it a lot more comfortable. Also, I trimmed whatever excess there was on the clips, because there was two extra holes beyond where I have it now, and they went beyond the leather portion of it. And I got it to where I wanted, where I knew I was going to carry it, and trim the rest off. And it's pretty much extremely comfortable right now. The gun fits it just fine, and that's how it looks. Let's see if I can zoom out. That's how it looks with the Glock 26 in the Comtech Minotaur holster. And it has, I have been wearing it for the past 2 weeks, and you could see it fitting to the gun very well. It's form-fitting now, and the longer you wear it, the more comfortable this holster is. There is a slight advantage that I can see that the crossbreed has. It is the distance from each clip. Now, the further the distance, the more weight it distributes, the less you feel of the gun, and that's where I think the crossbreed has an advantage. If you look at the two where the clips are, you know, it might seem minor as a comparison with maybe an extra 1.5 to 2 inches wider that the crossbreed's clips are, but it does make a difference. I noticed that the crossbreed's the length or the width of the distance between each clip, belt clip, does make a difference in distributing the weight. Also, if you look at the rear here, the indentions is just caused by wear, and if you can see here, that's where the hardware holds the shell together. This was actually the shell. I switched the shell from the P226 to the Glock 26. And it took a while. It actually took longer for them to get me just the shell than to get me the entire holster for the P226. But as you can see there, the hardware is actually starting to come through the, not through the leather, but you can see it imprinted in the leather. Still a comfortable, very comfortable holster, and I think it's very well made. But again, I wish the spacing between these clips were a little bit further apart, and I think that would help distribute the weight much better. Again, crossbreed is still an excellent holster. I've heard some people complaining, not really complaining, but they had issues with gun retention. Now, once the gun's in here and you're not wearing this, there is gonna really be not too much tension or retention of the pistol. Now, you have to figure that when you're wearing this, you know, your body's going to be backing up against this leather, and also the belt that's wrapped around it is also causing tension. So retention on these hybrid holsters is going to be somewhat loose if you're not wearing it. I find that now that I've worn this holster with this G26 for a while, it is starting to form to the gun. You can actually see some marks on the inside there. Still, even without wearing this holster, it still has slight tension. Okay. Now, it has actually more tension, again, when I'm wearing it, where my body is pressed against this leather here, the leather side, and on this side, you have the jeans, pants, whatever you're wearing, pressed against this side with the belt loop. So that causes a bit of tension there also. You can also adjust the tension by how tight you have your belt. A really disadvantage of this type of holster is, I'm lucky enough to wear, an oddball size in pants. I usually wear like a 34 or a 35, and I have to especially look for that size. And all I had to do was go up just one size, which is 36, which is very common. But what you do not want to go is two sizes higher, because then your pants get actually too baggy for this. Then you have to really cinch up your belt, and it just kind of works in opposite. So either wear your size pants that you're wearing now with this type of holster, and just don't put as much tension on your belt. And it should hold it just fine and be just as comfortable as if you were wearing a one size larger pants. But so far, again, I've only worn this for 2 weeks, and very comfortable. As I mentioned, I wish these belt clips were spaced just slightly further apart. Maybe the front could be moved further apart to distribute the weight a little bit more even. But still a much more comfortable holster than any other inside the waistband holster that I've worn. Also, I have a belt slide that I picked up. This is a Don Hume, just a plain black. I think the model is a JIT slide, and this is particularly made for this subcompact Glocks. And this is to be worn, during the winter time, where I'm able to wear a jacket. But surprisingly, with this holster, as tight and as high as it rides on your body, I can easily conceal it with a t-shirt. It prints slightly more than a hybrid holster, but this is, if you're not into inside the waistband holsters, this holster really rides high and tight against your body. Of course, wearing a one size larger shirt would cover it up even more. But this is the preferred leather holster, or outside the waistband holster, for me anyways. And this is something I would not carry on hikes in Arizona or anything, because I rather have the thumb strap retention, just so it's another added safety as far as running around and jumping off rocks and stuff. That's just an added safety. But as far as running around town, I prefer this type of holster. But that's just a quick update. This is a Don Hume JIT slide. And this is almost similar to the Yaki slide that Galco and some other companies make. And wanted to show you the new Glock 26 shell for my Comtac Minotaur. very, very nice holster still. Very comfortable. And I think the more that I wear it, the more I'm going to like it. But pretty much that's the update on that. One more thing. I did get a chance to take this to the range and shot with the extension on and without the extension, and either one, it just feels comfortable, just feels natural to me. I'll show you that it's unloaded. But I love the trigger on this, and surprisingly it's extremely accurate for a short barreled subcompact pistol, and I'm really liking this pistol so far. But that's the update on it, and let me know what you think about the holsters. Thank you.